How's it going, everyone? Before we jump into episode 3, I just wanted to let you know that OhmNohmNohm is a collective of musicians, artists, tech heads, and writers with a passion for chiptune music, retro gaming, and old computers. We aim to share information and our passion to all of you. If you are interested in submitting audio, video, or articles to OhmNohmNohm, please send us an email at mikey@omnomnom.com. Now, on with the episode. Welcome to episode 3 of Chiptune Tech. My name is Anthony Hom. Chiptune Tech is created to disseminate information regarding the tech side of the house when it comes to chiptune hardware, mods, accessories, and all of the amazing innovations that people are doing to bring a brighter future to chiptune music. In this episode, I will be talking about the Prosound mod, specifically for the Gameboy Color. The Gameboy Color was the third offering from Nintendo in the Gameboy lineup. Released in 1989, the Game Boy Color was capable of producing 32,768 colors, and being able to display up to 56 different colors at the same time on its screen. The Game Boy Color took two AA batteries, came with an infrared wireless communications port for linking to other Game Boy Colors, and introduced a new ergonomic design that fit well in your hands. The Game Boy Color came in a number of hip colors that were too legit to quit. First pioneered by Trash 80, the Prosound mod gave chip tuners clean, line-level-out audio and a noticeable boost in bass for their Game Boy, Game Boy Pocket, Game Boy Color, and Game Boy Advance. This episode will only cover the basics of the Prosound mod. For a more in-depth view of the Prosound mod, I suggest you listen to episode 2 of Chiptune Tech, where we went over the Prosound mod for the DMG-01 Game Boy. The Game Boy Color is known for having more static noise than the DMG-01 Game Boy when using LSDJ. The Prosound mod will remove a good amount of the static noise from audio recordings. As with the DMG-01 Game Boy, the Game Boy Color also has points on the circuit board for you to perform a pre-pot and a post-pot Prosound mod. The pre-pot Prosound mod sets the line level output to maximum volume. The post-pot Prosound mod gives you control of the volume output via the volume knob on the side of the Game Boy. The following are audio clips comparing the audio from a Game Boy Color running LSDJ from both the headphone jack at 100% volume and pre-pot Prosound RCA jacks. Both audio clips were amplified equally due to the audio signal from the Game Boy Color's headphone jack being very low, even at 100% volume. Both audio clips were recorded with the same settings. The first clip is recorded from the headphone jack at full volume on a Game Boy Color. The second clip is recorded from RCA jacks at full volume via a pre-pot Prosound mod on a Game Boy Color. The most noticeable difference is that the Prosound recording is much louder than the recording from the headphone jack. The next two audio clips are comparing the static noise that is audible from both the headphone jack and the Prosound jack on the Game Boy Color. The audio clips are from empty chains being played in LSDJ. Both clips were amplified equally to give a representation of the differences between the levels of static noise. The first clip is recorded from the headphone jack at full volume on a Game Boy Color. The second clip is recorded from RCA jacks at full volume via pre-pot Prosound mod on a Game Boy Color. In comparison, the Prosound mod does reduce a great amount of static noise from the recording, but it does not remove it completely. How you compose, record, and modify your Game Boys are all personal preference. There are chiptune artists that embrace the noise of the Game Boy Color and use it to their advantage stylistically in their music. If you are not looking for a pristine sound in your music, recording from a Game Boy Color may work best for you. If you are interested in performing the Prosound mod on your Game Boy Color, a quick Google search will be able to yield a number of tutorials. That's it from me for this episode of Chiptune Tech. Thank you all for listening, and again, happy modding.